I just got into Alabama and look what I found.
Hey everyone, welcome to Seeking New Horizons. I'm Paul, and I'm currently on a mission to travel to each of the lower 48 states. So come along and join me for the adventure.
This is so cool. I'm such a huge fan of Smokey and the Bandit, and I come across this in Alabama. What a great way to start this date. I am looking so forward to this. And here is camp for the night. Out here in part of the National Forest. I don't remember which one it is, but I'll put it down below for you guys. I don't know how well you guys are gonna be able to see this, but it's just a nice little secluded campground. And there is a gorgeous sunset going on right now, just beyond the tree line in the clouds. But just look at that sunset. But what a great way to spend my first night here in Alabama. Just absolutely gorgeous. I'm going ahead and I'm just going to pretty much get settled in here at camp, enjoy the beautiful sunset that's happening behind me, and I will see you all in the morning. Good morning, everybody. It was a pretty peaceful night here at camp. No complaints. If you do notice a little difference in my audio, I am testing out a microphone here. I just wanted to try something different. I was using a microphone that kind of attached to the top of my little stand thing or whatever you want to call it that I hold. But I really wasn't liking that, so I stopped using that and I was just using my cell phone microphone for quite a while. And now I'm giving this a try. I'm going to just see how I like it. It is wired, but if I like it, I'll probably invest in a Bluetooth one, but I just want to test it out. So if you would, just let me know down in the comments if you noticed a difference in the quality from the beginning of this video till now forward. But I'm going to go ahead and get ready. Actually, I'm pretty much ready. Just need to jump in the van and go. But we're going to go ahead to Chichia State Park. It's supposed to have the highest point or the highest mountain here in Alabama. So we're gonna go check that out today. I'm here at Lake Chia at the Chia State Park. I believe that's how you pronounce it. It's actually really pretty down here. It is a little overcast today. You can see by the clouds. This is just one small area of the park. The main area is kind of up the mountain a little ways. But I came down here just to get out of the clouds it's actually up that way, or maybe it's more that way. But either way, there's a mountain back there somewhere. But I came down here because I was gonna make some breakfast and maybe use the restroom. But the restrooms are closed down here for the season, so I'm probably gonna head back up to the mountain. I was going to maybe use one of the pavilions they have down here, but they have signs on there saying not to bring in any like cookware, like barbecue grills, fryers, stuff like that. So I'm not going to take my camp stove down there. I could probably commandeer one of these picnic tables, but I would also like to have access to a restroom. So I'm thinking I'm going to head up to the mountain or back up the mountain, find a spot up there. There is a trail that comes down back here. And maybe we'll just hike back down later today. So I am up here at the top of the mountain now at the state park. And I just kind of want to give you a comparison to what it's like up here versus what it was like down at the lake. As you can see, it's pretty foggy. So yeah, the visibility is pretty low. Not a whole lot to see up here at the moment. But I'm hoping to just maybe make some breakfast here and hopefully just wait this out and we can get some scenery in. I decided to come back down here to the lake because it's, well, the view is a little bit better and it's not quite as chilly. So I think I'm trying to make breakfast down here somewhere. So it just started sprinkling, so I moved into this pavilion. I'm not sure if I can cook here. These rules look a little weird to me, but it's a picnic pavilion, so it doesn't make sense to me. Why wouldn't you not be able to cook here? So here's the rules. What doesn't make sense to me is no other cooking equipment allowed. Smokers, ovens, hibachi, deep fryers, etc. The only thing that's here is that. So I don't know what they're talking about. Technically, it's a camp stove, so it's not a hibachi grill. It's not a stir fryer. I found a power outlet. So while I'm waiting for this weather to clear up, I'm gonna get some video editing done. All right, we're just have to try and give this a go. It's about a quarter till one, and honestly, I think it looks worse than it did this morning. But really quick, while I was down at the lake having, well, it was a few hours after my breakfast, but a nice couple from Florida stopped by with their son. So Warren and Bridget, if you guys are watching this, I hope you guys have safe travels, and it was nice meeting you two. But we're gonna just go ahead and see what we can see. I don't know if any of you have seen Sleepy Hollow with Johnny Depp. It's actually one of them. I actually like the movie, but these forests with this mist and fog kind of giving me, you know, vibes from that movie, kind of all kind of cloaked in mystery. At least, I don't know, that's the vibes I'm getting. Not the view I was hoping for, but still, this is still pretty neat. This has kind of like that, like I said, Sleepy Hollow kind of mysterious vibe going for it. I think it's still pretty cool. This is kind of a great example of sometimes things just don't go the way you plan. And you have two options. You can either be all mad and upset about it, or you can try to find some sort of enjoyment and beauty in it, or enjoyment in it, or the best in it. I mean, this is a scenario where I was able to find some beauty in it because I'm out here in nature. But I think it's time to head back to the van. I'm not quite sure what I'm going to get into next. They have a tower I think we can go up, so maybe we'll go check that out real quick. There it is, everybody. Alabama's highest point. Chehaya State Park elevation looks like 2,407 feet. And you can actually go up in that tower. Well, Definitely can't see anything really out there today. Can see the van though. There's a little bit better of a shot through the open window. Fortunately, like I said, can't really see anything today, but we are at the highest elevation in the state of Alabama. The only way to get higher is to be on an aeroplane. That is a really cool place. That tower is almost kind of got a medieval feel to it. You're walking up the stairs, water's dripping down the walls. It's really cool. I'd definitely recommend the state park if you're ever in Alabama. You need to come here to, was it Jehea State Park? I'll put it down below again. But yeah, this is definitely a pretty cool park. They have a lot of camping here too. If I already didn't have plans to be somewhere else, I would probably consider staying here a few nights. Of course, I think I would prefer a little bit clearer weather. But with that said, I'm gonna go ahead and head out of here and head to my next place to camp for the night. I'll see you guys there. Hey everyone, it's actually the next day. I apologize for not getting back with you when I got to camp last night. Honestly, I got here, the sun was setting, I crawled in the back and actually fell asleep for an hour. I was a little tired. I am here at Pine Glen Campground. I actually got a really sweet site here in the back of the campground. And I'm currently the only person here. Like I said, I got a pretty sweet campsite here in the back of the campground. There's even a trail that goes up to the river. And currently, like I said, I am the only person here. I have the whole campground to myself. There was a truck camper here last night, but they left this morning. So it's just me unless someone else shows up. But I've actually been kind of busy this morning. I woke up, took a walk, explored the campground, decided I really liked it here, and decided to stay an extra night. I was only gonna stay here one night, but after walking around, I was like, I wanna stay two nights. So after breakfast, I actually went and collected some firewood, got the kindling all broken up. I'm gonna attempt to have a fire tonight. I don't know how well it's gonna go. It rained last night, so all the wood here is wet, but I'm gonna give it a try. But in the meantime, let's go down that trail I was telling you about and check out the river. Like I said, there's a trail right here by my campsite. But now you see why I wanted to stay here one more night. It's just absolutely beautiful and really peaceful with nobody here right now. Tomorrow it's supposed to rain all day, so I'm gonna take tomorrow and just kind of do some errands and do a few other odds and ends. Friday is supposed to be nice. I think Friday I'm gonna try and hit Lookout Mountain. So I will cut in with you all once I get to Lookout Mountain. Unless I get that fire going, then maybe I'll show you a little bit of that. Good morning, everybody. I'm here at Little River Canyon National Preserve. Say that 10 times fast. I actually tried to remember it and record. I've taken this like 10 times. Here in Fort Payne, Alabama, which also happens to be the home of the band Alabama, which we might go check out a few things associated with them after our hike. So let's get started. Oh, I can hear the waterfall. There it is. Oh, Oh my gosh, this is so amazing. Definitely not the biggest waterfall I've been to. I think it's only like 46 feet high, but it is the most impressive waterfall I've ever been to. I'm sure all the rain this area got yesterday, as well as the previous two nights, has definitely contributed to what I'm seeing here today. This is just simply amazing. That was really impressive. Made it back to the visitor center, got my passport stamped, and as you can tell, I'm back in the van already. I don't know if I've really have kept you guys up to date on my passport here, but I've gotten quite a few stamps. I got Anarubi Falls. Those are the Indian mounds. Let's see here. That was the Plains Depot. I didn't record any of that, but that is actually where President Jimmy Carter, couldn't think of who it was, ran his campaign. So I stopped in there and got a stamp. Obviously the Everglades. And I got my Little River. I did both of them. So this one is the Little River Canyon National stamp. And this is actually the Trail of Tears, which actually is part of this area. But I have one more stop I want to make before I wrap up this video. And here we are, Fort Payne, Alabama, home of Alabama. So at the Little City Park here, they have a little tribute to each of the members of Alabama. This is their hometown. They do have a museum here dedicated to Alabama. It's like $10 to get in. I'm gonna go ahead and skip that. Maybe I'll hit it up next time, but if you're ever in Fort Payne, Alabama, maybe you should go check it out. But I'm gonna go ahead and wrap up this video here. I'll see you all in the next video where we're gonna continue our adventures here in Alabama. That just worked too good.
Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, consider giving it a thumbs up and leaving a comment down below. And if you're enjoying this content, consider subscribing and don't forget to hit that notification bell.